Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. In this video, I'll show you how to disable cloud access on your Unifi Dream Sheen Pro. The same tutorial can be applied to Dream Sheen or Dream Sheen Pro Max or probably any other Unifi devices. So what does it mean when you disable the cloud or remote access? When you are using Unifi Cloud services, you can access your Dream Sheen remotely when you are not connected to your home network using Unifi UI services. You can set automatic backups for Unifi OS or applications. These backups are stored on cloud and you can restore them from there. When you disable the cloud access, that means you'll not have any remote access, which is better for privacy and local control, but then you'll have to manage your config backups by yourself. When I initially set up my UDM Pro, I used my Unifi Cloud account temporarily, but then I kept adding more and more devices and never got a chance to go back to local access only. Finally, last week I decided to disable cloud service and go on pure local only access. Now, to disable the cloud or remote access, I had to reset my Dream Sheen Pro to factory settings. And then I have to set it up again without UI Cloud account by using the local admin account only. Thanks to Unifi powerful backup and restore features, I didn't face any major issues. Please be advised, once you perform the factory reset, you will have to connect to your Dream machine using Ethernet cable to restore the backup. So please make sure you have a PC or a laptop with network interface card and the Ethernet cable before performing a factory reset. Alright, let's start with the video. As you can see, this is my main router at home where I have created Wi-Fi networks and VLANs. I have blocked traffic from some countries where I was getting attacks. I have set up few firewall rules to protect and isolate my network using VLANs. I have started using Unifi Protect recently, so started to add cameras into my network. This was one of the major triggers to disable remote access on my network and keep it to local only access. To start, the first step is to take backups. First one will be the OS config backup, which can be taken from Unifi OS dashboard under console settings. This backup includes the admin and the users. One of them will be the owner of the console. When you set up your Unifi device using cloud account, it will make your cloud account as the owner of the device. When I set up my UDM Pro using the Unifi cloud account, it made my Unifi account the owner of the Dream Machine, which caused an issue when I was trying to restore the settings. I'll explain this later in the video. Next, I'll have to take network setting backups. This is most important backup as it will contain all the network's VLANs, security and firewall rule settings. For network backup, I can see two options. As I was connected to cloud, so I have few backups which are sitting at Unifi Cloud under my account. I can download those backups, or I can simply click on the download latest configuration file by clicking on download link and then downloading the settings only. Next one is to take the backup of Unifi Protect setting. I just added one camera recently into my network, so I'm not overly worried about the recordings or the settings, but I'll still take the configuration backup only. If you have any other application on your console, you might have to take their backups as well. Alright, so all the backups are ready. Let's reset our Dream Sheen Pro to factory settings. It will give you a warning, so click on factory reset to proceed. Keep an eye on the local display on the Dream Sheen. It should give the status of process, and once it is complete, it will tell you the default IP address to access the UDM. Make sure your network adapter is set to obtain IP address automatically. Or if you have set it up manually, you are in the same subnet as your Dream Machine. Access the Dream Machine using IP address shown on the local display. you should see the setup wizard. Let's start with the setup wizard. On the first page, when you click on Restore from Backup, it will take you to the login page for the cloud account. But since we want to set it up locally, so I'll go back and then click Next and then proceed without UI account. Accept the terms of service and set the password. You can test your internet speed. I'll skip it for now. The next setting is very important. It has detected my existing network subnet, which means if I select to keep using the existing subnet mask, it will help me retain my existing network settings. So I'll keep it checked and finish the setup. Once the setup is complete, it will take you to UDM login page where you will see a certificate security warning. Proceed to Unifi login page and enter the password which you just set up. Here, the first thing we need to make sure that all our applications are up to date before we can restore our backups. So here as you can see, I need to update the network application. I'll click on update to update it. Update might take some time. While this is happening, please give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Also hit the bell icon to get notified every time I release a new video about smart home automation, storage and network security. Alright, let's try to restore the Unifi OS backup first. The Unifi OS backup contains the admins and the users. Since we have set up this dream machine locally, that means the owner is now the local account. Now, when we are trying to restore the backup which was taken previously, it had my Unifi Cloud account as owner, so system is throwing an error that owner in the backup file is different from owner of this dream machine. So we can't restore the OS setting backup. We have to redo Unifi OS settings manually. And I don't think for a home user like me, this should be a major issue. For example, setting up the time zone and creating user accounts again. So I am not overly worried about this. But thankfully, we can restore a network setting backup, which to me is most important part. So let's go ahead and restore the network setting backup which we took earlier. Console will go offline temporarily once you restore your backup. Once the restore is complete, we can access the dream machine using the IP address which should be the old IP as per the backup. Please be advised, since admins and users were not imported, so your password will be the same which you set up while setting up the dream machine after the factory reset. The restore should bring back all the settings and configurations. My Wi-Fi access point started working again and I could see all the clients were connected back to it. Let's check the Unifi devices. I can see my switch and my access point, but my camera is still missing. I believe this is because we couldn't restore the Unifi OS backup. So let's install the Unifi product manually and restore its settings. Installation might take some time, but amazingly, once it was complete, it automatically picked up my camera with its network settings. But I'll still import the previous config backup just in case any settings were missed out. Unifi Protect will reboot and go offline for a few moments before it returns back to normal operation. Before I wrap up this video, let's quickly check the network settings to make sure I got all my configuration restored. I'll have a quick look on my Wi-Fi networks and VLANs to make sure they are restored as per the previous configs. Then let's check the security settings, where I had some country restrictions and most importantly, the firewall rules. I invested quite a bit of time in thinking and setting up all these rules as per my smart home setup to isolate my IoT devices from my main network, and I didn't want to go back and do this all over again. This is where I was super impressed with Unifi's backup and restore feature. It did an awesome job and I hardly had to do anything after I factory reset my Dream Machine Pro. I simply restored the backup and it was good to go. Just to report, I did face a small issue where a few of my client devices which had fixed IP address assigned to them got a different IP address instead of their fixed IPs. This broke my automation in my home assistant for a while, but this was quickly fixed by a simple reboot of the device or the Dream Machine Pro. After the reboot, fixed IP addresses were successfully assigned to the subject device, and it also fixed my home assistant automations. Other than this, I just had to create my local user account manually again, as I couldn't restore the Unifi backup, which was also not a big deal. I think all credit goes to Unifi's powerful features, which really made the whole task very easy and simple. Alright, that's it for this video. Please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I'll see you in the next video.